Hey community, this is Dr. Hugh coming at you again with another webinar. And today what I want to go over is your immune system and your white blood cell count, whether you have a low white blood cell count or you have a high white blood cell count. We'll be diving in this topic. I'll tell you, a lot of people that come to me, they have either high white blood cell count or low. Generally speaking, most people that come to me with chronic conditions have a low white blood cell count. They go to the conventional system. Maybe you go into the conventional system and they say it's just normal. It's normal that you have a low blood cell count. Or maybe you've had a elevated white blood cell count for years and years and years. And they say that's just normal. That's just how your body actually is. That's not the truth. If you have low or if you have high, there's an underlying cause. What is the root cause of the problem of your white blood cells being high or low? At the end of the day, your white blood cell count is very, very critical, and you need to have that in the sweet spot. And I'll be going over what exactly is the sweet spot range. So if you had some blood work, go get your blood work and look at your blood work while you're looking at this webinar so you'll understand what's happening with your body. So this is what you're looking at right here is a standard blood work. So if you do this panel here, you're going to see that this is the white blood cell count. You can see this white blood cell count is 5.7. Now, due to space, I kind of cut some things off. The range really is 4.0 to 11.0. This is the normal standard range. So you can see this person right here is the white blood cell count is within what I would say the functional range. Now, when I look at blood work, what I'm trying to do When I'm looking at blood work, this is what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to get your blood work in the sweet spot. Like, where do normal healthy people live? And that range is generally, I would say, around 5.0 to 6.5. So if I see a lab that says 7 on there, the white blood cell count, so if this would say 7 on here, I'd be like, you know, that just doesn't, it's not really grooving with me. It tells me that there is some, like, maybe some potential low-grade mild infection happening. We need to look into that. Now, if you come to me and your white blood cell count is, let's say, 4.5 on the low side, I'm saying, no, there's some chronic systemic, long-standing systemic infection that's wearing your immune system, your white blood cell down, which is your immune system. You have to realize your white blood cell count is your immune system. It's not your red blood cells. It's your white blood cell count. That's your whole entire immune system is wrapped up in that. So it's very, very critical to have the white blood cell in the sweet spot and have you balanced. Now, I'll be going over this in a bit so you'll understand if you're balanced or if you're not balanced. So here you have down here, you see this is the white blood cell count. And the white blood cell count comes in basically 5 different categories. So if you look up here again, so if you're looking up here, so we have the white blood cell count, which is right here. And then the white blood cell count is made up of 5 different components. 1, neutrophils, 2, lymphocytes, 3, monocytes, 4, eosinophils, and 5, basophils. So you have the white blood cell count, and if you look all the way down here on your blood panel, and this is kind of a standard blood panel, you'll see the different components of your white blood cell. So this right in here is your entire immune system, and all these numbers here, all these neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils represent what is your total white blood cell count, just to orient you to that. Now, when we look at your white blood cell count, the neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils. This is kind of like what they look like under the microscope. So you can see clearly that they are different. They look different, and when they look different, they actually have different functions. So different components of your white blood cell in your body do different things depending on what's happening in your body. So this down here breaks down what each of these things do. So we have your neutrophils. So the neutrophils is really for bacteria. So if you have a bacterial infection, generally your neutrophils are going to go up. Now, if you have a viral infection, your lymphocytes are generally going to go up. And then here, if you have your monocytes, I don't know if you remember the kissing disease or mono, right? The kissing disease or mono, your monocytes go up. And then your eosinophils, if your eosinophils are elevated on your white blood cell count, this can indicate that you have some kind of parasite, small bacterial overgrowth. So on a functional level, when you look at the subset of the white blood cells, it can kind of give you an indication of like what's happening in your body. It's just not normal. Like if you have an autoimmune disease, you deserve the right to understand what's happening with your body, and let's figure that out. So if you're out there and you need some help, get a hold of me. Give me a thumbs up down below if this is on YouTube. Give me a comment. We need this information to get out. Then down here, we have eosinophils, monocytes, and then basophils is kind of like an allergic reaction. All right, so this picture is really, really critical. I want you to understand like what portion of your blood is actually white blood cell count. So when you go and give blood, like they spin blood, right? They'll take blood off you, then they'll put it in a little vial. And then what they do is they spin this blood very, very fast, and different things separate here. So what you're looking at is right here is 45% of your spun blood is actually your red blood cells. So if we go and look at this, so the spun blood right here, the RBC right here, this right here is going to indicate how much red blood cells you actually have. That is measuring this portion right in here. Now, then we have the plasma, which is 55% of your blood. So what the heck's the plasma? So if you look at your blood work in here, this right here is going to be all the plasma stuff. So you're going to see the salts and the minerals and the water and the proteins like total protein, albumin. You can see that this is going to be standard blood work. Okay. Now this is the most significant part right here is 1% of all that blood has to do with your white blood cell count. So this is the white blood cell count right here. Only 1% of all your blood right here. Only 1% has to do with the white blood cell count, which is your immune system. So what is that telling you? That is telling you that 1% is very, very critical. So if that's out of balance, you're going to be out of balance. If that's out of balance, you're going to have autoimmune disease or a possible autoimmune disease or an increased immune system or a suppressed immune system. So this is where you really got to dive down in your case. And if you have some kind of chronic condition, you probably have some dysregulation with your immune system, your white blood cell count. So we need to investigate in that so you understand what's going on. So this 1% right here has to do with the neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils. Okay, so if you really look at this, this is pretty incredible. 1% of all your blood is your white blood cell count, and it goes to these five different categories. Now, I really like analogy, so I'm going to give you analogy because I think analogies really, really work, and I love analogy. So we have the Ford Motor Company. So the Ford Motor Company is your white blood cell. Now, the Ford company makes many, many different types of cars, right? They're going to make the Ford Focus. They're going to make the Fusion. They're going to make the Edge. They're going to make the Taurus. They're going to make the Explorer. All these are subsets of the Ford Motor Company, right? So the way I would describe this is we have Ford right here. So we have Ford, and then we have, which would be the white blood cell count. Then we have the different subtypes of your white blood cell count. So the subtypes would be the neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils, right? Or the Ford Mustang. Everyone knows a Ford Mustang. The Ford Mustang and basically an F-150, a truck, are going to be doing two completely different things. This is how you have to envision your white blood cell count. The 1% that God gave you is you have some Mustangs, and then you have some Ford trucks, and their function is completely different depending on what's going on in your body. But at the end of the day, we need a balance of all the system. So the Ford is just the white blood cell count, and then we have the subtypes, which are the neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils, and they each do something different. So this is just a great visual. You know, if you're watching my content, you guys know that I love visuals. So this would be a high white blood cell count. So right in here, this is your red blood cell count, and all these other ones in here, these colored ones, they are components of your white blood cell count. So here we have a high white blood cell count, which is the Ford Motor Company, and all these ones in here, all these different ones are the different representations. So this is the eosinophils, the basophils, right? Then we have the monocytes, so you can see how they look different. Now when your immune system is suppressed, you have less of the white blood cell count. And if you have less of the white blood cell count, you are more susceptible to every disease known to mankind. The white blood cell count is your immune system. It is the military. Okay, so right here, if you're looking at your blood work, you can grab your blood work and you're going to see something like this. You're going to see white blood cell count. You can see that. This person here has a 5.7. Now on this lab here, they consider normal range 3.4 to 10.8. Now, depending on where you get your lab done work, this is going to be It's going to vary, right? Each lab kind of varies. There's no exact set standard. So this is a lab range. So you can see this is very, very wide. Now, when I look at blood work, I'm looking at where do healthy, normal human beings live that have a normal, regulated, a homeostasis immune system? And that range is 5.0 to basically 6.5. This should be 6.5. That's what I like to see. If I see lower or if I see higher, I'm starting to think your immune system is dysregulated. We need to take a look at that and figure out what is happening when it comes to your white blood cell count. Now, these are what I consider to be generally high. So when people come to me, generally they've had basic standard blood work like this. This is like this to check your white blood cell count, your monocytes, lymphocytes, check the five subcategories is like costs like $10. It's super cheap. Okay. Now, so a lot of people come to me with these labs and I look at these things. So the white blood cell count, here's 9.5. You can see the range right here. So I'm thinking, you know, this isn't good. Like there's some kind of infection going on. So if you have a chronic infection, your body's being wore out. So what's happening? So then you have to do the investigation to figure out where the infection is coming at. Why is that happening? And at the end, I'm going to go over some possible solutions that you might need to look at for your case to determine what's happening with you. Here's another one, 9.8. You can see the range here is 4 to 11. This one's 3.4 to 10. So it ranges. Here's another one, white blood cell count. Now this is definitely elevated. This is 15. This is lab high. But I'm telling you, the sweet spot here is 5 to 6.5. That's where you want to be. Now, even if you're in the sweet spot, that doesn't mean that your white blood cell count aren't dysregulated. I'll be going over that in a second here, too. All right, so now here's low white blood cell count. So again, you can see this range right here. Let me kind of blow this up. This range here is 4 to 11. This person is 2.5. So that's really, really low. So why is that low? There's lots of things that can be causing why that's low. This is where we need to start to investigate. Why is your white blood cell count low? Why is your white blood cell count high? I've had people that come to me and said, well, my white blood cell count has been high for 10 years. And they just say it's normal. And I ask, well, how long have you felt like shit? And they say, 10 years, all right? So, like, just because, this has been elevated for 10 years and the conventional system doesn't know what's happening doesn't mean that it's normal. It just means that the tools that they have aren't what you need, right? You need to look outside the box to get yourself better. All right, here's another lab. We have 3.3. You can see the range in here. So 3.3, that's low. That's not good. Here we have another one, white blood cell count. 3.5. So you want to investigate and see what's happening with your white blood cell count. All right. So what I'm going to get into is probably the most important portion of this lecture. So take your time. You can re-listen to this. If you have questions, reach out to me. If you watch this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, share this. So there's some new advanced testing. And what this advanced testing does is we can actually break down your white blood cell count more specifically. Now, when we talk about your monocytes, eosinophils, basophils, and neutrophils, your lymphocytes here, all right, so if you look at your blood cell count, we're looking at this right in here. Your lymphocytes are the most, I hate to say most, the lymphocytes are the subtype of white blood cell count. So remember, we have Ford, and then we have a Ford Mustang, and then we have the Ford 150. They do completely different things, and they're designed completely different. So this lymphocyte pattern right here can be broken down into many things. So now we have, you know, let's say we have a F-150, and you can get, we have the F-150 right here, and you can get a lot of different F-150s. I'm not a big like truck guy, but I know you can get F-150, you can get F-150, you can get a F-250 and F-350. You can get a cab with extended. So now you're getting in subspecialties, right, when it comes to cars. Now, when it comes to your lymphocytes here, so when it comes to your lymphocytes right here, they can also be broken down into all these different categories. We have T cells, we have B cells, we have T helper cells, we have cytotoxic CD8 cells. Now, if you're getting confused, I just want to let you know, like, there is testing out there that can very specifically break down these lymphocytes, which are the most significant portion of your white blood cell count. And if any of these are dysregulation, when it comes to specifically your lymphocytes, You can have an array of different autoimmune diseases. You could have a suppressed immune system. You could have an immune system that's going too much. We have T helper cells. We have TH1, TH2 ratio. We have TH17. We have percent regulatory cells, TH17, natural killer cells. So all these things right here are subsets of your lymphocytes. Now, why am I sharing this with you? Because there's too many people suffering with chronic conditions that never have had the investigation to figure out what the heck is going on. So if you're going to look at this slide right in here, okay, so let me orient you on what you are looking at right here. So this right here, this is the total white blood cell count right in here. So you see this? This is normal. So the white blood cell count is normal in here, right? This would be the, basically this is the, if you remember the sweet spot, I like it to be 5.0 to 6.5 right here. And this right here is basically, it would be 5.4. That's the reference range there. So if you look at this, the white blood cell count is within normal. And now we're specifically just looking at your lymphocytes. And your lymphocytes, remember, have a whole bunch of different subcategories. Now check this out. You see this right here? All these are the different subtypes that you can have. And then look, you can have high, low, and then you can have in range. Now all the subsets, look at this person here, has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 subtypes that are high, and he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 subtypes that are low. So what is this telling you right here? This is telling you that his white blood cell count, specifically the lymphocytes, are way out of whack. But if you would have done just a $5 white blood cell count, it would have came back normal. This is where you need to do the investigation to figure out. This is why people come to me and I do a guided plan to figure out exactly what is occurring with the immune system. And this is just one component of all the different things that we do. But this is a really critical component. So what are some things that can be causing your white blood cell to be dysregulated? You might have an autoimmune disease. You might have low vitamin D. You might have food sensitivities. Maybe you're sensitive to gluten, dairy, sore. Maybe you're sensitive to almonds and you're eating those every day. Or maybe you're sensitive to nightshades and you're maybe eating tomatoes or eggplants, and you're sensitive to that, and that causes an immune reaction, and your immune system is getting wore out. Generally speaking, I generally don't see people that have elevated white blood cell count. When they come to me, people have chronic conditions. Generally, they're on the low side of white blood cell count. You could have a pathogen. You could have Lyme. You could have mold in your body. Lots of people have mold. And when they're in mold, guess what happens? Your immune system is fighting and fighting and fighting and fighting mold. And if you're living in a mold environment, or if you used to live in a mold environment and the mold is in your body, this is going to cause a problem. High insulin levels, hyperglycemia. You could have too much sugar. You could be eating too much sugar, too many carbs. You could be pre-diabetic, stress. Maybe you have low blood sugar and high blood sugar. Maybe you have chronic inflammation, right? There's tons of reasons why you'd have chronic inflammation. You need to look at that. Maybe your hormones are late. Maybe you're low in DHE or pregnenolone or progesterone or testosterone or estrogen. So you need to look at these hormones, low testosterone. Maybe you have a yeast problem. Maybe you have a candida problem. Maybe you have poor detoxification. Maybe you have C. difficile. Maybe you have H. pylori. A lot of people have H. pylori and have no idea that they have it. Maybe you have some kind of chronic infection. Maybe you have a leaky gut. Maybe you have a leaky brain. Maybe you have sensitivities to dietary protein. So if you're overwhelmed at this, I'm not trying to overwhelm you. I'm just trying to give you concrete data, concrete information, so you can understand, like, heck, this doctor here is explaining some stuff to me. Maybe this is why I have this problem, right? This is what I'm trying to do, is explain these problems so you can understand. You can give a light. There should be a light at the tunnel that say, hey, I understand. Maybe I can get help. Maybe with a guided plan, you can get better. This is really what comes down to. I'm just the orchestra conductor, right? I just know all these different tools. I can get someone and we can move forward and start working together and reverse your chronic condition. That's what it's all about. There's too many people suffering. My dad died in the medical system at 69 years old, 400 pounds on 14 medications every single day. And I don't want that to happen to you. I don't want that to happen to your loved one. I don't want that to happen to your mom and dad or your kids or your neighbor or your person at work or the person at the grocery store that you may know or your friend's mom or dad or your kids, mom and dad. There's too many people suffering out there, and they don't need to be. You just need a guided plan. And remember, is where there is help, there's hope. Take care. This is Dr. Hugh.